Hello everyone. I'll start my session. Okay. So today what I'll do is I'll create a solution or a product wherein Hyperprasad mobile app, and it will be a mobile app to manage all the home automation. So basically, and if you have heard about IoT or the Internet of Things, it's basically it's all about the smart devices and how you can use that smart devices to manage everything, you know, so through the different interface. So whether it's a physical interface or it's a digital interface, like you have seen in your home, the AC. So you have that console, you know, like from there you can control your AC. Similarly, we have got like so many different digital devices and like smart bulbs, then thermostat. So that's basically the AC. Then even the kettle, or there are so many different devices that we can manage using the Internet of Things, different technology like BLE or Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and then for the other sectors like the industries and so on, so there are like other technologies. So I'll just give you a small overview of that, and then I'll get into the designing of a mobile app. So let me get started with this. So this is me. I'm Manpreet, and I'm a user experience design consultant and a UX strategist. I work with a lot of startups, a lot of businesses, a lot of corporates, and even like big IT firms. And I have gained a lot of experience in working in both lean and agile environments. So lean is basically wherein like all the startups uses this lean method, wherein they go with the with a small MVP, and then they go test, learn, improve, and so on. Whereas agile is basically a sprint, wherein like you do extensive research and then you do the design. So that is it. So this is me, and you can follow me on these platforms. And today I'll be doing this basically doing the wireframes from the idea that I have, and then if we have the time, I'll do the prototype. Otherwise, I'll do the hi-fi designs. So this is it brief for today. So basically, we'll be designing a home automation system. So that home automation system should allow the user to create his own digital ecosystem, and then he can, by using the app, add device, remove device, and also like add users, manage users. We'll see that when designing the app. And this format I generally use for designing all my project. So I've used the same here. So I do mention these things, like what is the project name, what is the task. Then if the client has some tagline, I'll try to put that in this sheet. Then along with that, what is the exact challenge, or what is that you're trying to achieve. So basically, you're trying to create an ecosystem or the smart app, and that is what I've written here. And then who is the company, what is the date when you're starting or you are working on this app, and what is your roles and responsibilities, platforms you're creating the product for, what are the key metrics that will define the success of the product, who collaborated, if you are the single person or they're like a team who's working on the app. So I try to capture in these kind of document, in this format, when I'm working on the real life project. And also I try to capture like which country, which place, which geography I'm trying to target by creating this particular app. So this is it. So I generally follow the UX process whenever I am designing any application. So I basically try to understand the challenge or the problem statement or what has been asked by the management or the team to design. So I try to understand what it is, and then basis that, what I do is I try to do the research and the analysis, wherein I try to understand who the users are, and then also try to understand like who is the company, and what are the objectives, why they're creating the application or the product. And then I try to align the two, like the user goals and the product goals and the business goals. And then after everything is done, like after the research, I try putting everything in understandable, in a format that would be understood by everyone. So basically different artifacts, be it like customer journey or like pain points or like empathy map and so on. So I try to put in different formats so that I can present my data or the research in the right format. And once I'm done with that, I start doing ideation. Design thing happens with the team. We work together with different stakeholders, even we call users at times, and then do the ideation and then create or ideate on different solutions. And once we have the solution, we do the prototyping. So that is basically start doing the design and then start doing the prototyping. And once prototyping is done, we test it in the real world. We go out and test the product with the real users and see like whether the product is useful or not. Though at this stage we won't have the final product, but since it's a prototype, we'll get to understand if the customer or the user is having any problem in using that. So this is the right stage to test. Even like before that also, at every stage you should test, because it's always good to get the insights, like more feedback from the users from time to time. And if you do the testing before finally developing your product, it's easy, because it's easy to, you save a lot of money, save a lot of resources, because doing modification and changes in the prototype is quicker and less costly than doing in the final product. So whenever you are also doing any kind of design or the product development, do follow the UX process, try to understand who the users are, their pain points, and then try and create your solution, and to keep in mind to solve the problems and the pain points of the users. Right, so this is UX process, and I always talk about this. So basically, whenever you're creating a product, do consider these things. These are very, very, very important. So the product should be useful, it should be usable, it should be desirable, people should be willing to use your product, and findable is whatever you're presenting on your app, people should reach that. And all the features, functionality should be there on the app and very clear to the user. Accessible is like basically they should be able to use it. And credible is like it should look like a legit product rather than like something scammy or something like that. I also always tell everyone to follow these principles. So basically, whenever you're design for the real users and understand the business goals, understand the user goals, if you have some data to back up, so basically if you have done some research and if you have data, so back up your design or the solution solution with the right data, and understand users and their mental model. And whenever designing, create a design system, follow the design system and consistency, and along with that, make your product useful and accessible, and don't try to complicate things. Like, keep it simple. Less information is always good in design. Use simple languages and use right kind of typography, and do take feedback again and again by testing your product at each stage of the UX process. And also when designing, do understand these things. So these are very important elements or the components or the features of the mobile physical device. So basically they have camera, microphone, contactless can be accessed using in the device. GPS is also there, phone calls. So basically all the history can be easily accessed by the applications. And accelerometer is there, compass is there, then touch. So basically it's all about touch, NFC, IRC, sensors, face readers. So these are there on the device, on the smart devices. And when you're designing the application, try to remember this, keep this in mind, and then do the real solution. This will really help you understand. So basically if you're creating a solution, and in case of asking for the input, if they can just speak out and record and give the instruction, so well and good. So you should use that feature. So then in that case, microphone can be really useful. So understand what you can do for the user and how you can simplify his life. So that is the job of the user designer. Right, so let's get started. So basically today what we will do is, or what we'll talk and make is the application for home automation. So, and let's understand like what is home automation. So basically home automation is basically automating your system or your home, making your home smart. So here what you do is you use smart devices to make your house or the environment which you want to make smart. And here basically you use a lot of devices like what we have done is like access control, video surveillance, alarm systems, then other systems, we'll talk about it later. So basically these systems, what you do is like you use this with the help of a gateway, and then you use a it could be like an interface, a physical interface like we have in the case of the AC, or we can also use mobile apps or like tablet or any web interface to control these devices, this smart or the IoT devices. So basically, in order to make something smart, in order to make home smart, you will need these IoT devices. And we'll see while designing the app like how we do that. And when we talk about the IoT devices, so the communication happens between the application and also the devices. So how What is the technology behind that? So these are few of the technologies. There are many more technologies, but these are few of them, like Wi-Fi. So you can connect with your camera, with smart camera or like other similar product, or the speaker with the help of Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. And there are other technologies like Zigbee, Z-Wave and others. So if you want to get a list of that, I'll share that too after this completing slide. So there are different technologies, and different technologies are used for different purposes. So if in future, like if you're given an assignment and you're asked to design any solution for smart home or smart controlling and managing your any smart devices, then you should understand these technologies, and you should know like what each technology does, like when can Wi-Fi be used, or when can Bluetooth or Zigbee can be used. So you should remember that. And when designing similar kind of solutions or such kind of solutions, you should remember that by using these technologies, you can do three things majorly, like the three things. So one is like you can monitor everything. So this is basically you can monitor your home like through the cameras and so on. So that's basically what you can monitor. The second is you can control this device. You can control, you can switch on and off. You can like in the case of the AC, you can manage the temperature, increase, decrease, and so on. And automation is basically you can create your own flows. So basically you can manage everything and create a schedule around what should happen at what time. Like suppose in the morning a smart alarm should automatically switch on, so basically at 6 o'clock. So you can program that, you can automate that using the system, using the product or the application that you will be developing. This would be possible only when you have the smart devices. And by doing the logical coding and design thinking, you can create these kind of logical experiences and the flows. So these are three things, that three at a very high level view what we can do using these smart devices. And so while doing my initial research, I came up with few of the features. So I put that down here. So basically the goals basically. So basically the user, if he comes on the app, he should be able to create his own ecosystem. He should be able to create his, like suppose he wants to use the particular application for three of his homes. So he should be able to use that. He should be able to create home one, home two, home three with the application, and then add smart devices within each group. So he should be able to do that. So that's basically the setup smart home ecosystem. So set up home, add, remove area. So that is basically home one, home two, home three. And then within home one, if he wants to add like different rooms, living room, drawing room, bedroom, kitchen, and so on. So he should be able to do that on the app. And then at the end, he should get an overview of like what's happening in that ecosystem. So how many devices are there on the in a particular home, or like how many are switched on, off, and what is the energy consumption, and so on. So basically, as you deep dive, you can improve your product and add more information and relevant information for the user. But since this is like a small workshop, so I'll keep it very small. And we'll keep it very limited. The second is like once you have set up your ecosystem, that is basically the home ecosystem, you can manage your devices. So basically you can add smart devices, you can delete smart devices, and then you can also manage services. So switch off or other controlling the devices, you know, these different features. And then you can also set up different schedules, whether like at what time it should switch on or switch off or other things, depending upon the kind of the device. Similarly, you might be having like multiple or you might want to add multiple users to the and provide them access to different devices. So you should be able to do that within the app. So basically you can add different users, you can delete users, you can assign different privileges, so and so on. And then also like full account management system, wherein like as a user, the user should be able to manage everything, like notification, settings, everything. And then others are like basically configuration, messaging systems, and help and support, and so on. So basically this is what I could think of, and this is like a result of a small like 4 to 5 hours research work that I did. And so we'll now start doing the design part. We started with the basic wireframing first. I'll do the wireframing, and then we'll start into the design. So meanwhile, if you want to understand like different technologies, I'll open one page. Can you see my screen now? The browser?
Yes.
Okay, great. So I was talking about the technology that's used in home automation, and when we talk about the IoT and the smart devices. So these are basically different technologies. It's LPWANs, then 3G, 4G, 5G devices, which are compatible with that. Then ZigBee, another mesh protocol. So these are different devices, different technologies. So Bluetooth, and that's, we call it as BLE, and Wi-Fi, and then RFID, the tags, what we have in the stores, retail stores. So this diagram tells what you can use at different, when grid working on different products. Right, like LPWAN you can use when you're working on like big projects, industrial IoT, smart meter, smart city, then a smart building, and so on. So if we talk about what I was talking about, like BLE and Wi-Fi, these are basically used in the case of smart buildings, smart home. You see, smart home and smart. So when we're talking about home automation, we use these. So BLE and Wi-Fi. So we'll talk more about that in this session. And also, like before getting into this, we should understand, we should know like what are the different smart devices. So I have this list. So this is the website called iotlineup.com. So they've categorized the devices, the IoT devices, into different groups. So basically home automation, home appliances, home energy management, home security and safety, health and fitness, information and entertainment, automotive. So these are different devices that you should be, or you can manage by using the smart app. So even the smart coffee maker or this smart alarm clock, thermostat, cameras, then voice controller. There are so many different devices that you can control using this app, right? So now let's get into the designing. So I'll start with the basic wireframe. I'll talk about like what and how we should be doing this. Okay, so what I have done is I have done some my rough sketches and rough homework. So I'll start sketching that on the whiteboard. So basically I've done some sketches here, so I'll just try to present that on the whiteboard, and then we'll talk about what each of these means. So when we talk about these home automation system, so in that case the applications is the interface. So application is the interface which will help manage all the IoT devices. So the user should be able to use that device, use that application, and the user experience should be like very simple, so that it's not complicated, and people or the user should be able to, like, by using few control systems, they should be able to manage those devices. So when designing application or the experience for this kind of applications, we should consider we generally consider and take two different use cases. One is like for the new user, the user who's very new and who has never used your application, that is basically the fresh user, and the other is like who's already an existing user. So let's talk about fresh user. So what should happen? So I should be asked to register. So this happens only after he has downloaded the app, right? So for the registration, so whenever I design, I try asking like minimal fields. So basically what it will do is I'll ask for full name, mobile, email, that's it. I'll not ask anything else, no social media account, nothing. So I'll just ask these, and then I'll ask him to continue. So once he continues, I generally ask for OTP. So OTP basically goes to both email and mobile. And once this is done, the user will land to the dashboard. So once he lands to the dashboard, since we know like who is he, because he has already provided us his name, so I generally try to personalize the experience for him. So basically I try to greet him, I try to welcome him with his name. So basically I'll tell if he is James, I'll tell James, welcome home. And then since he's very new on the app, so I'll create an experience and I'll ask him to customize or like create his own ecosystem. So let's create your smart home. And then, since he's there for the first time, what I'll do is I'll ask him to first add home, and then I'll ask him to add rooms. So let's start with the house. Let's add room or house. Let's keep it house first. So I'll ask him to add his house details. So basically, he can add it here itself, or I can open a small overlay pop-up, and I can ask him the name. Name of the house and the small description. So this is basically I'll ask in this. So once it's done with this, so I'll mark it as done, and we'll ask him to add second. So that's basically, in this case, I can do two things. I can ask him to add rooms or add devices. Now, why I have done this? Because there can be like different use cases. So we can have a user who has only one device, and in that case, he might not be interested in adding rooms. So in that case, he will straight away go to the add device experience or the flow, and then he can simply add the device. But in case he has like many rooms, he'll go to the second flow. So basically, he'll start adding his rooms. So basically, add room. So he'll give a name to it, and I'll ask like small description. Then I'll ask him to upload image. Right, so once this is done, so this will be done. And once this is done, then we can change the experience, and we can ask him to add the device straight away. In this flow also we can ask, or like we can create a different experience for that. So the next can be for the adding the device. Now this is little tricky, this is little different. So in this case, what we'll do is we'll ask him to choose the experience. And so basically, there are different ways. Either you can add the device manually, or you can ask add device so this is basically Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. So basically, if he clicks on any of these, the different experience will come. Basically, what will happen is like the device will search for it will search for the devices, Bluetooth devices nearby, and then if they are able to find, it will show the listing. Device 1, device 2, device 3, device 4. So, and then whichever you want to add it, you can simply select, and it will automatically get added. And then some success message will come, and it will get added. Right, so that's basically the automated experience. So basically, you're using Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, and then it will search for the nearby devices who's connected to the same network, and then it will show the list, and after that you can select the device and you can simply add. Other is adding the devices manually. So here what you can do is you can show different categories. So basically if I talk about categories, so as you saw there, so basically we can add top high level categories. So this can be like the lamps, this can be the cameras, this can be the smart speakers, this can be the appliances, and so on. Or the first can be the this can be the all, and the others can be the right. So we can add different we can show the listing of the devices. And then once you click on any or tap on any, so the experience of adding that particular, or the journey for adding that particular device will start. And this you don't have to worry, because each device will have its own experience, right? So it could be either through the scanning the QR code, or the BLE, that is the Bluetooth, or the third is Wi-Fi, depending upon the kind of the product that you have bought, or like the product that you have. So the experience will be different, and that you don't have, will not worry about that, because that will be different for all the different products, right? And once you have this, so this is for the existing new user. Now let's see for the existing, what should be the journey. Here what will happen is, so again the same thing, the welcome message will be there, same as we had earlier. And then we can also put like his image or something like that for personalization, and then we can start putting his so there's two ways, like, you know, you can either show the experience by his homes, by listing his houses or homes, or the other is by showing the or grouping all the devices together and then showing. So we can have two ways. So basically rooms, devices. So rooms, if we talk about, so then and on the top we can have here somewhere house one or house two, something like that. And then you can select, we can create some experience wherein you can select the different houses, and then the experience will flow. So basically if we talk about rooms, so in house one, if he has got like 5 rooms, so this can be the bedroom, a nice picture of the bedroom. Because when they were adding the rooms, we asked for the images. So if he has uploaded some image, we can show the image, and then we can show like the number of devices. Like if the bedroom has got like 3 devices, smart devices, we'll add that here. And also like if you have a smart AC there, so you can show the temperature also, 23 degree, or if the light is switched on and off, you can show that also. So basically we can repeat that everywhere. So this can be the drawing room, this can be the park, kitchen, and so on. So whatever room you have added, you can show that here, you can list that down here. Now if I talk about devices, let me just create this experience. So if we talk about devices, so then in that case we can show we can group all the devices. So be it TV, lights, or air conditioning, audio system, others. So similarly, we can list down, and then once you like, if we talk about lights, so we can have like five different lights. If we add like all the homes, so we should put the numbers for the good experience. So five lights, two TVs, something like that, four ACs, and then three audio system, right? So we should mention that, we should put it that. And then once you click on any of this, you can start managing and controlling this. Like if I talk about lamp, what you can do is you can so how many lights? Five. Lamp one, lamp two, lamp three, lamp four, and lamp five. And then you can start controlling this. And this can be all the human the colors. So basically you can control which color you want, from warm to cool to warm. And then you can manage this. You can have different controls for this, for managing this device. So this could be like, if you want this to be on, if you want this to be yellow, or if you want to the color to be some color, then you can control and find the right color and then apply it. And then you can, if you have added any favorites, so you can click on that, and then it will automatically get reflected, or the lighting will change, and so on. So this is basically experience of one managing, how to manage one device. So similarly, we can draft experiences for each and every devices. Like for TV, you can have something else. For the audio system, it will be something else. Audio system will have like one song playing on the device, and then you can even see the list of the song, and so on. So basically, you can manage everything using this particular app. Right. So now we have the basic understanding of like what this product is. So I'll get into the design, and we'll start designing the experience for one, the new user, like 4-5 screens, and then for the existing users. Right. So let me get into the design. I hope you all getting this. So basically, we'll start with the login screen or the register screen. I'm using Sketch for this. I'll use dummy content for this. Very close to blue. And if there's something that's not clear, or like you're not able to understand, just ask me. Thank you. So when working, you'll have to experiment a lot with colors, layouts, fonts, everything. I have no idea like what I'm doing. I'm just experimenting with I don't know like what will look good, what will not, so I'm just experimenting and trying to see like what will look good. Okay, so when you also are like, when you're designing in the real life, you'll also have to experiment a lot and see like what's working, what's not working, what's going with the brand guidelines, what's not, and so on. Because every company has their own brand guideline, and they define like what should be the language of the images, and also the copy, the font sizes, how should the heading be, and so on. So you should follow that. So now, since I will be using this buttons too many times, so what I'm doing is I'm trying to create it as a component. So in sketch we call it a symbol, so I'm doing that. And there is a guideline, or not a guideline, so basically you can follow a structure. So basically I want to create or put this particular component in certain order. So basically what I'm doing is like I'm putting this components, and then I'll put button, and this is wire, something like that. And later on I can go inside and I can create more colors. So basically okay, so first of all I'm going to create this color and add it to my library. Go in, I put the color here, yeah. And I can change the name to button to blue. Why not put it this? Perfect. This image is not looking nice, so let me try one more image and then we'll continue. So I can even go abstract. It's not necessarily that I should show the full drawing area or the bedroom also. I can even go abstract and do something different. So I think I'll keep this for time being. I can add some shadow here to highlight this. So this is done. So now let's go to the second screen and create the register screen or get started screen. And here what we can do is we can logically get this screen download. So basically once we know like the user is already a member or already an existing user, so we can straight away just ask like one, show one field, and then we can ask them to put the email or the phone number, and then we can straight away by verifying the OTP through the OTP we can ask them to log in. They don't have to enter each and every detail every time. So let me see. And once he enters this, we'll straight away ask him to get into the app. So basically we'll straight away take him to the app. So this is basically let's make it manual. Okay, so this is my name. Also, we have to take care of the interaction. So basically, the user has not filled the details, so we'll have to keep this as inactive. So we'll keep this as gray. Right? And also, like, we should rename it there itself, otherwise later on it will become very difficult to manage everything. So now we are done. Some content here, some smart copy. And now comes the main part. So basically, from here we start the experience of the new user. Since he's new, so we'll ask him to follow a few things. Follow and do something. So we can use some smart icons here, and then we can then they can add the homes, the details about the home, and then home one, home two, and so on. Or we don't want that, we can even ask them to add the schedule to go to the rooms, and they can straight away follow the process. So each will have its own flow. I'll straight away, because the device is a complicated one, I'll go with that. So let's go with the device first. I think I'll keep this left line because it's very easy to manage all the feature flows. Can add four in a row. Let's do that. Let's see how it's looking. For the timing, I'm just using a PNG. This one will be completely different. I'm just using any for the design purpose, but later we'll have to create, we'll have to keep the same stroke and now let's, this is lamp. Similarly, we can add other products. So now in this design I'm putting everything, I'm putting without any logic, but in the real app you gotta put everything logically. So what should come first, like what are the people or the devices or the services people are using the most, and then put those in the front at the top, and then the others can follow at the end. So but here I'm just using anything. So this is basically how that page will look like, and then each device will have its own journey, and then you can add the devices. Now suppose you have added like many devices and then you are a regular user, so how should the experience of the design look like? So let's see that. This is for the returning users. I'm just putting this indicator, but we can have a better experience for this. Now home one will have can have multiple rooms. So let's create those rooms. This room has AC, we can put the temperature also. So let's put 6 degree. So basically we can create one component and then use this. We can add all the different tools here, and here we what we can also do is we can, as we are determining these episodes. So basically, we here itself we can have two categories. Like one is the this is the rooms, and the other is the devices. So this is rooms. And we can put the number also here, like how many rooms. 8 rooms, 8. And devices, if we have like suppose 20 devices or 23 devices, we can put it here. And does it work as a tab? Is not looking good, we can create a different experience. You can create something like this. You can improve this further, but and then we can have other things, other information also here, like latest activities. If there is any alert or something, that way. What I'm showing is a quick work, but when you're doing the final design, you have to take care of the computer. Now suppose once you click on any of these, what will happen is you will go to the rooms details screen. Here, what you can do is you can, let's say we have lamps. suppose you have two lamps, so let's keep it as one. And we can repeat this again. Let's call it as two. And then what other details can we have here? Whether it's switch on or off, we can mention that here. Similarly, we can have other devices here. And then you can have final one screen wherein that you can control the device. I'll create one more screen and then we'll run this. So, now suppose you are on the lamp screen. So how will that look like or how will that work? So we'll have to experiment when creating the app. So once you are in the third level, so you can start giving small this is good. Okay, so Philip, two lamps, lamp one. So this is basically Philip lamp. We can have the other devices here, and then here we are doing it like we'll manage one device, we'll highlight that here. So with some indicator. So we can switch on. So we can put a control here, so we want to go. We can have both like control depending upon the type of device it is. For switching on and off the device, making the light to be white, or if you want to customize the lights, so we can use this color. And then we can create your own flow or like own pattern. We have some favorites, so we can show here. So then here what we can do is we can add the colors. And depending upon what you select, the color of the light will change. If you selected this portion, then the light will change to pinkish or like reddish or something like that. So this is basically how you can create flow for each or the experience for each device. I think it's already late. I'll not stretch it more. So this was like a rough quick work, but this is how we do the design and this is how we the real designing of the application, the interfaces and flows. I hope this was helpful.